Hi. In today's world, GPU is no longer a luxury. We deal with huge data set that requires us to use complex algorithms. These complex algorithms are in turn compute intensive and time intensive to train. Typically, a data scientist training on a regular infrastructure has to wait for hours for the model to finish. And the data scientist have to go through hundreds of iterations to find the right set of features, the right set of hyperparameters, the right models itself. It is like the data scientist sitting idle most of the time waiting for the model to finish. While there are other ways of distributing an algorithm, like you can do a distributed TensorFlow or a distributed XGBoost, you can run a distributed training on large data set. The problem is these algorithms, when run on distributed, takes more time or more iterations to converge on the data set. That is one way of doing an faster training. But GPU, on the other end, is pretty good for this compute intensive task, as a lot of this complex algorithms requires heavy vectorization. And GPU has a lot of cores that can help with the vectorization of the model. And this in turn reduces the training time substantially. That allows the data scientists to more focus on the model iterations and validation and everything, rather than just waiting for the training to finish. But the problem with the GPU-based training is not all algorithms or packages are supported today. TensorFlow, XGBoost, SparkML is coming up with support, provide some kind of support to it. But the typical scikit-learn libraries, which has all the algorithms have been tested over time, does not have any GPU acceleration. One such package I'm going to talk about today is RAPIDS. Now, RAPIDS is built on top of CUDA primitives. And we can directly use CUDA for model development, or we can use QDNN for neural network development. But that is typically like hard to implement. That's why we have packages like Keras, TensorFlow, simplifying and making it high-level API, simplifying access to CUDA interfaces. Now, RAPIDS on the other end uses a Python-like interface that's pretty simple to use. So if you are familiar with pandas, if you are familiar with scikit-learn, RAPIDS is basically a drop-in replacement for that. I'm going to talk more on that. Now, RAPID not only takes care of model development, it tries to simplify the end-to-end process of machine learning development, starting from engineering the data till the model development to the deployment through an GPU-based simple interface. So all this can be accelerated on GPU. And this comes with very low serialization cost because internally it uses PyArrow. Now, when we talk about RAPIDS, there are multiple packages that are available in RAPIDS. The very first package is QDF. QDF is kind of CUDA data frame. It is very similar to pandas. You can use the same function of pandas. You can use the aggregation logic of pandas, but you're just using a QDF. What it does is once the data is in GPU memory, it accesses it and it processes it. That is QDF, which is a pandas drop-in replacement. The second is QML, which is a scikit-learn drop-in replacement. It has built-in estimators for a lot of algorithms. While it is the algorithms are still being built into RAPIDS, it is over the time like going to have all the algorithms that scikit-learn support. There are pretty good algorithms, some of the common algorithms that we use already supported in CUDA-ML, QML. The next is QGraph, which is more for graph analytics, and it's an NetworkX package replacement. And then finally, we have QDNN, which we all typically know. It's basically for the neural network interface and everything. RAPIDS includes support for multi-node and multi-GPU training. It achieves the parallelism by using Dask internally. So basically, it uses Dask to distribute training across multiple nodes or multiple GPUs. Some of the open source library are already supported by Dask. XGBoost is one of that. Support for Spark is coming. And there are a lot of commercial products which have also started supporting RAPIDS. In the next few set of videos, I'm going to take through the details of RAPIDS. Basically, we are going to go hands-on on RAPIDS. We are going to say how to develop the first machine learning job. Then we will talk about how to develop a data engineering job. And finally, we are going to also see the benefit of RAPIDS over the typical scikit-learn library. And also, what are the disadvantages of RAPIDS today, which over the time may mature, right? We are not sure, but stay tuned for my next set of videos on RAPID. Thank you.